Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Lights, Camera, Trash. We have a very special guest today. You've seen him here on the channel before. I'm, of course, referring to Tom Hanks.
What about his wig?
Hi, I'm Tim Hanks. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Aren't I likable and stuff?
I actually found him scary in that.
Yeah.
He was like real tall and intimidating.
Really?
Yeah, you can cut that to horror music.
Hello, neighbor.
We're playing the Da Vinci Code, a game filled with puzzles, and Elise, it seems you already have a question.
They thought that 10 unique users were going to play the Da Vinci
Code.
Right,
we know at least 15 people will play this.
Every twist and
well,
turn.
Sometimes you're like, you play a game and there comes a twist so out there that you're like, oh man, I want to play this with my cousins and my mom.
Jesus fucked Mary Magdalene. Spoiler.
Don't spoil the Bible for me. I was going to read it. Do you remember what a big deal the Da Vinci Code was?
Yes.
And then people recommended it to me, and then I respect those people less.
Human beings found a commonality in the Da Vinci Code, in the text, in that it was the only book most people finished.
Listen closely, did Tom Hanks' brother do the voice?
The position of his feet reinforces the reference to the pinnacle.
Hey there, Buzz!
Move the towel.
Yeah, there's a clue under there.
Yeah. Oh, Todd Horrocks.
Todd Horrocks.
Todd Horrocks speaking.
I'm from the film Large.
No, that is the right number.
Ah,
it's
that's Audrey Tautou.
Audrey Tautou says,
Monsieur, a pleasure to meet you, Mr. Honks. Please, call me Da Vinci Code.
Would it be better if she was like a French-Canadian? I find the Quebec accent to be the most funny of all of them.
Oh, really?
Because he's like this.
It's like a swan.
You can't dub a movie in Quebec and then send it to France. They'll send it right back.
Look, I turned the subtitles on so you guys can
wow.
enjoy it.
Wow, okay, now the video starts.
Here we go. Who's Robert?
They've really captured the intense excitement you feel walking through a museum.
Talk to that guy again.
Stop talking to people. Find a clue.
Babe,
clearly can't leave. You're trapped in the area. You can't look at his body, so there's got to be a clue somewhere else. We should have all gotten copies of the book to see if we could outrun Elise playing the game.
No.
Yeah. Speedrunner.
I remember reading that
Pull
book
it
in
up
about,
on Audible, and let's see if we can
just roll it and just see how fast it'll go.
You can get through that thing in a day. It's like a Goosebumps.
No, we don't need a walkthrough. It's the first thing.
I think the game broke. Why don't you just try restarting it?
Use your other save point. We gotta look at this guy's donger again.
We get to.
I love how your pitch for this, James, was this will be the finale. This is gonna be so great. It's definitely bad enough to be in a trash can. I'm not sure it's bad enough, like, for entertainment.
Okay, so I have to tell the captain that the message is from an injured friend back home and then asked to use the restroom.
Elise, can you explain everything that's happened that I've not paid attention to from the whole game?
It's really hard to focus on this with you guys chatting behind me.
All right. Oh. You should stop.
Okay, well, just be quiet so you can read.
Imagine just how terrible it would be to be called to a murder scene and then have diarrhea. Like, because can you really excuse yourself?
Well, I'm saying Hanks has to pretend like he's shitting in there to throw the detectives off his...
Oh, that makes much more sense. That's what a good detective would do.
Wait, he went in there with her, though.
Mm-hmm. Well, she's got to pretend she's shitting, too.
Oh, okay. So they're like, oh, man, I got real bad diarrhea. I had ice cream before I came. And they're like, oh, me too. Oh, I had custard before I came. Let's go in the bathroom. And you see them, Jesus Christ, fuck Mary Magdalene.
I think there's been so many movies where people kick down bathroom doors that the companies that make those should really reinforce them at this point.
You're right. Someone should write and shoot a sketch that acknowledges the trope and then subverts it.
Yeah, if only there was a show that had a sketch like that.
I just want you to remember, as you're going through this game, 2 is the lowest prime number. Good luck.
2? Wait, what?
2 is the lowest prime number.
Good luck.
All right, at least that's what you're born to do.
What? Now I don't know how to do this. I couldn't pay attention to what he was saying because you kept doing your prime number
just
bit.
Just remember what I told you. Oh, man, I got real bad diarrhea.
The male taint?
Words is my is my least best quality.
The Nemo. And he looks at me and he goes, Sophie, of course, the Nemo sale.
Sin.
Oh,
of
what?
Of course.
Sin meat.
Ooh la. Sin meat, hola.
Hola, sin meat.
I'm pressing the hint button, but nothing's happening.
Uh-oh.
Hey, Google. What's the answer to the first puzzle from the Da Vinci Code on Xbox?
The Mona Lisa.
The Mona Lisa! We're so
Google
dumb.
Google comes through.
But maybe
I was gonna say that.
Probably. Yeah, the tip of my tongue.
If I had been able to listen to the game, we probably would have gotten it.
Unfortunately, we don't have that option.
Whenever I see the comments on a Funhaus video, they're like, I wish those guys would just shut up so we could listen to the game.
Yeah. The most popular and the best version of our channel is one where we sit quietly and say nothing and play the game through in its entirety.
That's why I love hanging out with you guys outside of work. I don't feel any pressure. It's almost like hanging out with no one.
There's so many moments where we're hanging out with Zach, and then we'll have like a long conversation with him, maybe 45 minutes or whatever, and at the end of it, he'll go, "Who's there?" The best thing about Dan Brown is that he's not even a good writer when it comes to coming up with his own name.
Guys, come on, help me out here.
Mm-hmm. All right, okay, so you need to get past the guards, right?
Yeah. Flash him your beaver.
Dress up like a rabbit dressed up like a woman, and then you can distract anything.
I think you should just go out and let them know what you're doing, and maybe they'll be cool with it.
Tell them your granddaughter Jesus. Maybe what happens when you creep towards him?
Pontius was a bitch. Yeah, just stay in the shadows.
No, there's no way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Are you kidding me?
Attack!
Oh, he got you!
Okay, X.
Oh my god.
B.
Oh okay. My god. Hold on,
you hit the button.
That's like a pretty high-level crime.
Jeez.
Oh, wow. Like law enforcement.
All right. X.
Yeah, I blocked it. Nice. Nice job. This is exciting, even though you're not doing anything.
I wish this whole game was just a series of museum fights.
My best favorite is the other card over there.
Not my job.
Does she know karate in the movie?
Yeah
absolutely. So many things on screen.
I don't like this.
So much stuff on the screen. It's like a freaking CVS receipt.
Oh my god!
Oh, whoa! Hey, all right.
Push him down.
Oh, okay.
He's hired here to protect the museum, and this 112-pound woman goes, no! not like this!
Oh, no. Oh,
he's
no.
Choking her.
Oh.
Oh, shit.
You got three guards against one Amelie?
Oh my god!
That was like a psychic punch.
Violence.
Oh my god!
Oh my god! Is she down?
She's dead.
See, when do we sneaking. Get to the next level?
Well,
you can't do this, Zach. Every time we play a game, you can't just ask for us to hit the next
damn
level.
Damn it!
Anybody see any weapons?
Well, maybe there's something near.
Oh, there.
You sneak up on.
You gotta
arms.
Crouch. You gotta crouch.
Oh god. Oh,
okay. Pick that up.
Press A.
Take.
This should be useful.
And then sneak up to him.
This could be useful to knock someone out.
All right. And crack
stealth attack. Things are always bright. Okay.
What the fuck?
Someone finds him, they will call for backup.
All right, let's find a clue.
Oh.
Aha.
Oh, man.
First try.
That's what Dan Brown said when he finished the novel.
Kerthunk. The body hits the ground and her bosoms shake with a heavy, like two heavy pendulums swinging from her collarbone.
God, they are huge.
She moves into the next room to take a look at the Mona Lisa and can't help but notice that Mona Lisa also has huge knockers.
Oh shit, Mona Lisa's a painting?
So, we learn now that Sophie's grandfather, murdered, was a member of a secret society.
Yep.
Victor Hugo. All these famous men. Leonardo da Vinci. No women.
Oh man, another word puzzle.
Sweet.
It's Mona Lisa.
It's Elvish.
He just said they look like random symbols, and this is literally his job as a symbologist.
It would have been cool if this game had all these plaques. Actually, you could like pop them out and read them, what the art was, and look at the art. That'd be cool.
So you'd want just a game of a museum?
I think that's what she's saying.
I've actually been to the Mona Lisa.
So have I.
It's all right.
It's smaller than you'd think.
It's smaller, and it's behind glass.
Well, yeah, because some asshole tried to steal it.
Funny.
So he used to not be famous.
Yeah, well, you know, you live and you learn. But when I went to the Mona Lisa, I just zoomed right up to it, and you're not supposed to, but since I was in a wheelchair, they were fine with it.
Oh, that's
and then
nice.
I was there with Aaron, so I was like, Aaron, set me down on the floor, and you get in the chair and go do the same thing. But they remembered the chair.
Oh. Hey, so you're just signing random letters to...
Symbols
right now.
Yeah, but I don't know how I get out of this.
Well, you start with the one. That's your Rosetta Stone.
If Words of Friends has taught me anything, I guess it hasn't. This is a pretty good, like, representation of how I felt about the movie when I saw it, though. Not often that you can translate a level of boredom into a different medium so well.
They did it.
I am one of those people that, like, when there's people talking around me and someone's speaking at me, it's so hard for me to focus.
Do you want to swap?
You chose a terrible career.
I just need people to
do you want to swap?
Da Vinci painted.
Those that knew between Bacchus and Uriel lies the clue.
Imagine if you wanted, like, an Xbox for Christmas and this was the first time you got it.
Good guys, it's getting good.
Is it? All we had to do was not say anything for 20 minutes and then you solve the puzzle.
When do we get to move on with our lives?
Oh my god, they're being
shit. Hey, come on, man. They're just zoologists and shit. Yeah. Let them be.
You want to know where I learned how to be a cryptozoologist? In the Marines.
They're kicking so much ass.
Oh, man. Who is a better fighter, Audrey Tattoo or Todd Sporks? Can we... switch to the game where you guys answer questions or
open house.
Okay, yeah, we can.
Oh,
do
yeah. Do you want to respond to a comment from the last video?
Let's
that you
respond
were in?
To a comment.
This
here.
Comment comes from D. Brown. I think the game looks great.
Mm-hmm. Thoughts?
Yeah,
look up a comment from last time Zach was in.
Yeah, let's just talk. Welcome to the open house.
Ulfer Fenrir says, Zach missed a big joke. When James slammed him on the sofa, he should have said, ugh, I can't feel my legs.
But
you can
see,
feel it.
That's great. But the problem is that I would just be misinforming people because I've always been able to feel my legs.
Yeah.
There's not much of them, and they're way too, look at how much hair is on, like, I got a real person's leg hair and a fake person's legs. I want to at least get to the Ian McKellen part. He's in this, right?
Is he? He plays a Pope?
He's got a cane. He's pretending to be disabled, and then they knock him over.
We don't say that!
And then the final code's in his cane.
He just keeps saying it.
Pretending to be a disabled.
Jeez.
What do you think I'm pretending to be?
Will Robert and Sophie survive another night at the museum? Tune in next time when we don't play the Da Vinci Code.
Oh, that sounds like a great out. That's where I would cut it.
Well, there's my gun. There's my spinneroonie.
Those my spinneroonie, little... my wallaby, down, turn around. My hook, bring you close.
My padungaroo.
I call this one the founder from down under.
My bangarang, boom, boom, stick.
I'd recognize that accent of yours. Are you from Transylvania? Yeah, I am.
I don't want to slow down the production cycle right now of this game.